generation or that generation is on the cusp of transition from women to do what they were supposed to do.
Or we would go, as a younger kid, we go to or you look at magazines, so you had the photo and the film, and people always as opposed to a painter, which takes it and moves it down into a singular frozen moment.
Sure.
And that kind of reductive thing, they're just different sensibilities.
Sure.
So if somebody, I've always been asked, would you ever like to make a film?
Right.
It's like I would have zero idea how to do that. I don't think I could sustain it or write a novel. I don't think I could sustain it in terms of the length of it, even though I could set up certain kinds of things that imply sequence or, and when I think you look at my paintings, you see that there was a moment before and there's a moment after. And you as a viewer kind of create that.
But also, it's interesting, when you were talking briefly about that painting there, I kind of got the sense that the sort of previous drafts, as it were, previous arrangements of that painting, where the naked woman had been there, was still sort of present in your mind somehow. Mm-hmm. There was this, the characters who had once been in that canvas and weren't there anymore seem to exist almost as ghosts for you, haunting that canvas. So there is a kind of temporality in some sense.
I think my process is, taking you through the labor of that process, I don't think is a great idea. It's like, we just watched an hour and a half of Confusion. It was deep. So I don't know, but I've learned a lot from cinema and photography, both in terms of point of view, compositional things, all that kind of stuff comes from that language rather than painting. When I started to paint, first of all, late 60s, painting was declared dead, so maybe you shouldn't be doing it. Unfortunately, if you're a painter, it actually is the way you organize your experience, and you see color and shape and this and that, and you put it into some kind of thing. You relate to the body, the somatic experience of pain. All those things are a part of being a painter. So for me as a painter, I have no question that's what I have to do. But there was a point where they thought if you've got to paint, you should paint abstractly, because that's at least more contemporary than painting figuratively. If painting were dead, figure painting was way dead, right?
But there were still really great figurative painters out there. There was like Perlstein has an exhibition on here now, and Alfred Leslie, who always equated your work with.
Well, when
those things, when you were,
well, when Leslie was, when I was coming up, Leslie was still painting abstract painting.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but I certainly know his work. And
well, you kind of hit a note all around. Well, they're a little bit earlier than you, but they, you know, you hit a note at a certain time and place.
Yeah.
The other thing I want to ask.
Anyway,
I was going to say about the painting thing was I had to actually look back to 100 years before to Manet and Degas, who were also influenced by the photograph, but had figured out what was important about the photograph in terms of the language, in terms of how the photograph caught a moment, how it codified shape, how it minimized detail in a way that, you know, they could interpret into a kind of fluid painting. So I had to sort of go back and figure out if I could pull any of that forward. That became part of the thing. But the other thing that photography showed me, which I didn't know I was looking for, was because it captures people in such a thin moment of time. Everybody's off balance. Everybody's off balance and everybody's in motion, right? And if you're gonna do a narrative, you need to animate it with motion. So you give somebody a sense of their body just starting to move forward. Well, now the narrative's begun. Where are they going? You know, are they going towards it or are they going away from it? Is it pleasant? Is it frightening? Is it, you know, whatever. You build the thing off of that. So you know, I would see somebody doing something, I'd take a photograph of it. You know, it's what I can't pose models, I can't tell them what I'm looking for. But you see something and you're just curious. It's like a meaningful gesture without it being meaningful specifically. Capture that and then put it into context where you say, where are they? Are they looking away from something? Are they looking to something? You know, blah, blah, blah.
Sure, yeah.
I see. I think I've read other people talk about Robert Angstrom and that kind of Updike.
What?
Well, Robert Angstrom and sort of Updike sensibility of American design or a character, I don't know. You know, it's a sort of disaster impending and a momentum going on, and maybe glory days behind in these books. It seems like maybe there's an easier correlation between painting and literature than with painting and film in some ways.
Well, the thing is that, you know, within painting, within art, the suburbs was not a recognized genre. It was something that had begun to happen in literature, Updike and Cheever and people like that, and in film, you know, like The Graduate as being an example. But it was something where the suburbs was considered a place of no content, and yet I'm of a generation, as are most of my peers, that grew up in the suburbs, and we actually know there's a ton of content in the suburbs and stuff. So, you know, part of it was about, yes, it existed outside of that, but how do you forge a permission inside the you know, rather restrictive definitions of art, of painting, in which people can see that, oh, well, suburbs is as poignant and powerful as the demi-monde or the pastoral or the historic or the, you know, the other genres, right? So.
Thank you. I know you're much in demand.
Can I ask the one question?
No, sorry, we can't have any more questions. We've got one more interview to do.
Just about Paula Rego. Yeah, did Paula Rego's painting come into your mind at all with that picture?
No. Paula Rego's paintings never come in my mind. I know her work, and I respect it, but I don't feed off it or use
by
it.
Yeah. Consciously, anyway.
We will see you tonight.
Yeah.
I'm coming to the...